Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will discuss about the algorithm of deadlock detection and recovery, and in one case we will describe the algorithm using a wait for graph where we are using single resource instances of each type. As we know that the system, if cannot imply any of the deadlock prevention or deadlock avoidance algorithm, then we will reach a situation where a deadlock can occur. Now, in this scenario, two cases that need to be considered. First, the system should then provide an algorithm where a deadlock can be detected in that system. And the second one is, if deadlock is detected, then we have to provide a mechanism to recover from that deadlock. Now, this deadlock detection recovery algorithm not only incurs the overhead of cost of maintaining necessary information for the detection and recovery and execute that algorithm, but also it leads to poor overhead of the reducing system performance. But we will use this if in any situation we reach such a scenario of deadlock detection. Now, today we will discuss about the single instance of each resource type resource allocation system. So, if the system is using a single instance of each resource type, then a variant of resource allocation graph can be used to detect and recover from that system. This graph is known as a wait for graph. A wait for graph can be constructed from a corresponding resource allocation graph where each PI to PJ requests that PI is requesting for a process PJ to request and release this resources that is been executed by PJ. Now PI needs a request that is executed by PJ. So the resource allocation graph is containing the request stage and the assignment stage, but here in wait for graph we will remove all the resource vertices from the graph and we will collapse the corresponding edges. In the wait for graph, it is only a process graph where a process to a directed edge is removing and telling us that the request has been satisfied. Now, a edge to PI to PJ exists in a wait for graph even only if there exists in a resource allocation graph of PI to RQ and RQ to PJ. That is a request edge of PI to RQ and an assignment edge of RQ to PJ for an instance type of RQ. Now, if these two edges are present in the resource allocation graph, that can be combined into a single edge in the wait for graph. Now, we will see that how to do that using a resource allocation graph and converting into a wait for graph. So, as we can see, there are 5 resources of each instance type and there are 5 processes in this resource allocation graph. Now, for constructing the wait for graph, we have to remove all the resource vertices and only consider the process vertices. First, we will put the process vertices in the wait for graph. So, here we can see in the resource allocation graph considering P1 and P2. So, process P1 is having a resource type R2 and process P2 is requesting a resource type R1. Process P1 is also requesting a resource of R1 which is being allocated to R2. So, now process P2 is requesting for R2 to release its resources. So, now there will be a edge on the wait for graph which will contain from process P1 to process P2 as it considers the P1 to R1 and R1 to P2. Now we will consider P2 and P3. Now process P2 is requesting for a resource R4 which is being allocated to a process P3. So now indirectly process P2 is requesting for a resource that is being allocated to P3. So there will again be present an edge from P2 to P3. Now we will consider P2 to P4. Again we can see that process P2 is requesting for R5 that is being allocated to process P4. So there will be exist a edge from process P2 to P4. And last we are considering P2 to P5. As we can see that process P2 is requesting R3 which is being allocated to process P5. So process P2 is requesting for R3 which is being allocated to P5. So there will exist a edge P2 to P5. Now we will consider P3 with P4. Process P3 is requesting also R5 that is being allocated to P4. So there will exist an edge from P3 to P4. And the last allocation is for R2 that is allocated to process P1 and process P4 is requesting for it. So process P4 has to wait for process P1 to release resource R1. Now that process P4 is requesting for a process R2 and that is being allocated to process P1. So there will exist an edge from process P4 to P1 as it will release the resource R2 to be allocated to process P4. So as we know, the system will be in deadlock state if and only if the wait for graph is containing a cycle, and there we need to maintain a wait for graph for every set of processes and an algorithm that is to be invoked periodically to check that the cycle has occurred in the wait for graph or not. And the cycle uses n square number of operations where n is the number of processes in the system. Here we can see in the resource allocation graph also and in the wait for graph there exists a cycle. That means for this particular system, the system will be in deadlock state or may occur a deadlock state. In this way, single instance of each resource type deadlock can be detected using the wait for algorithm and then can be recovered using the cycle detection algorithm. If any cycle is happening, then we will not allocate that rate of resources to the processes and the process must wait for the resources to be actually released by the other process. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikira and subscribe to Ikira.